It's a hobby, it's an addiction, it's a habit, it's a lifestyle, it's pretty much everything. It's like an underground culture for the sneakers.
My name is Will, also known as King Poetic 01. I've been collecting sneakers for about 22 years. I don't know how many pairs of shoes I have. I really don't know. Sometimes I go in my closets and I look and I'm like, oh man, I haven't seen these shoes in God knows how many years. I just broke these out, meaning this is the first time I've ever worn them. These shoes came out in 2001, it's 2012. Sometimes it takes me to 5 to 10 years to break out a new pair and wear them.
It's like a wine collector, basically. He'll buy like a Dom Perignon from like 1960 and he'll, you know, put it in the cellar and leave it there to age. He's keeping it away for a long time so he's ready to break it out and let it go. It's nothing like getting a new pair of shoes. It just makes you feel better about your day, about the week, everything.
Hey, this is not stuff that, you know, you're supposed to wear. You're supposed to appreciate it as art. Last year, Nike finally released the Back to the Future shoe that people saw in the movie. It said Nike Air Mag, and people were like, when are those ever gonna come out? Is that a real shoe? Oh my God, and for, what was it, 10 years, 20 years? People were talking about that shoe. They had a big event in Hollywood. Michael J. Fox was behind it. It was for a Parkinson's disease charity event. This was just only released through eBay auctions. Some of these pairs sold for up to $90,000. They'll give you everything you want. You just gotta pay the price. And this is it. This is all hand sprayed with using Zoltone. These are all LEDs that actually light up. These shoes charge, the charger for them right now. This was part of something that was just a long time in the making, something special that Nike did, not to make money, but just to do something that is a crowd pleaser. Which is again part of the entire phenomenon, what I like to call sneaker art.
I have a 3-year-old son now. He, you know, before he was even born, I used to always purchase sneakers, baby sneakers. My wife used to always tell me, why are you buying baby shoes? We don't even have a baby. But I always said, you know, whenever I have a kid, you know, whether it be a girl or a boy, I wanted them to be fresh. We'll be right back.